الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. We thank Him, praise Him. We always seek His assistance. We seek Allah's help. We ask Him to increase us in knowledge that will bring us closer to Him. We ask Allah to guide us and to increase our iman, to increase our conviction and our faith, to increase our love for Him and His Messenger and His religion. Continuing on from the last khutbah about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as rahmatan lil alameen, a mercy to everything that exists. His message, his religion, his way of life, his teaching, it's rahmah, it's mercy, it's success, and it is the path of happiness in this life and the next. Not only the next, in this life and the next. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this khutbah is about mind readers, those very intelligent of us that they think they can read minds of other people. They can interpret actions and saying of other people, even though they're very wrong. They just assume this brother's from this culture, they must be this way. This brother speaks like that, he must be this way. The sister dressed like that, they must be this way. And they have a pattern, stereotypes, something that's blinding them from actually being humble, being open-minded, not mind-readers, being positive, being kind, being generous. The Prophet ﷺ said, اجتنبوا الظن فإن الظن أكذب الحديث أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of course, in the Quran says, وَاجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِنَ الظَّنِّ إِنَّ بَعْضَ الظَّنِّ إِثْمٍ. This is what they call in Islam, Arabic is dhan. Dhan is assumptions, interpreting what the action of the people is, what they mean by what they say. Even though they say, brother, I love you for Allah's sake, in your heart, in your mind, it's, oh, hey, hypocrite. He's not honest. I've seen him. Yeah? This is shaitan speaking on your tongue, if you think like that. This is not from Allah. This is not taqwa. This is not piety. This is not righteousness. And I will give you the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a treaty, signed peace treaty for 10 years with the pagan of Mecca after the Hudaybiyah. And they betrayed. And they went and attacked and killed his allies. And the Prophet ﷺ said, that's it. We don't deal with any betrayals. We have to go and take over Mecca. We have to cleanse it from these idol worships. But he doesn't want bloodshed. We know the story. He doesn't want fight. He wanted to go and surprise them. That he is there, they can't resist, they will hand over. But one Sahabi from the Sahaba close to the Prophet ﷺ in Medina, he wrote a letter. He wrote a letter to Abu Sufyan in Mecca. Be careful, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is coming with an army. There is no way you can face them. And he sent the letter with a woman. He didn't go himself. And the woman hid the letters inside her hair. And she travels hours away from Medina. And Jibreel came to the Prophet ﷺ and said to him, there is such and such event happened. Yeah? it's written a letter and with this woman in such and such area. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought Ali, Zubair, Talha, all these giant horsemen, and he says, as fast as you can, stop this letter from getting there, give this letter. They fly literally to that place and they found the description and they stopped the woman and they said to her, give us the letter. She said, what letter? And she pretended to not to know. What letter are you talking about? Ali ibn Abi Talib moved out and says, look, the Prophet ﷺ never lied. You have the letter. Either you give us the letter or we strip search. She dug her hands in there and she got the letter. And she gave it to them. They took the woman, gone back to the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet ﷺ called that Sahabi who wrote the letter. Hatib, his name. Hatib ibn Abi Balta'a. This is a treason. This will cause a bloodshed. This will cause the pagan to get ready and ambush and wait and kill. This is horrible mistake. And the Sahaba were really, really, that's it. This man is not Muslim anymore. Yeah, he must be fake, hypocrites. And the Prophet, look at this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's applying in practice what he's telling us. Don't assume. Don't just assume because he did this, must be this. I'm so smart, I'm so intelligent, I understand people. I'm a mind reader. All of us do it with our husbands, with our wives, with our children, with our brothers, with our sisters at home. The kids don't do anything and we interpret, they must be watching this and that. The wife doesn't nothing. He must be, blah, blah, blah. This is not Islam, wallahi, this is not Quran. This is not what Allah and His Messenger teaching us. The Prophet ﷺ called him. And he told him, "Ma hamadak ala hadha?" Can you explain? Allahu Akbar. Please explain. And he says, "Wallahi, you're messenger of Allah. I know you are victorious. I know that you are the messenger of Allah. I believe the 100%. I never went back on my faith. But I have families in Mecca. I have no tribes to protect them. I want to just have a favor on the leader. So if we go and the fight happens, they will remember me and they won't torture or kill my family. That's the only reason." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Sadaq," saying the truth. Oh, the Sahaba, this is... No. Nobody should ever say anything to hurt or to insult or to cause any pain for him. Allahu Akbar. Tell me, please, who was your friends or your brothers or sisters or relative committed a treason like this? That because of that, you boycott them. You don't respect them anymore. You don't talk to them anymore. You don't, yeah? Many in this community with people of a very high caliber, very intelligent, lots of energy, lots of ideas. And because of that, the whole community is losing. The whole community is losing in their collective power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with. Ijtanibu kathiran min adhan. Allah says most of assumption, bad assumption, negative assumption is wrong and is sin. Mind blowing. Honestly, mind blowing. The story is coming. There is in the history of Islam, we talk about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we talk about the Sahaba, talk about the scholars. In the history of Islam, there's a scholar very famous in his time, maybe the most famous. His name is Al-Karkhi in Iraq. And he's sitting with the scholars, teaching them, talking, discussion, and in the river of Iraq, in Dijla, a boat at night time, they could hear the music. They could see the problem. Young people on a boat having a party. And they say to him, "Shaykh, Imam, make dua, may Allah curse them, make dua against them." And he make dua, "Oh Allah, as you give them happiness in the dunya, give them happiness in akhar. Ameen." Every one of us says, I don't know what you're going to say. Yeah? This is a grand scholar. They say, "We asked you to curse them, to make dua against them. I'm not making dua for them." He says, "I made dua for them. If they go to Jannah and Akhirah, means they will repent in dunya. What will harm you if they repent and turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" They say if you misunderstood a word that any brother, sister, husband, wife, family said, if they say a word that you think it's negative and bad, you have to spend so much energy thinking they don't mean it. They mean this or this or this or this or this or that. And if you can't, with all your energy, find a positive interpretation, say there must be a positive interpretation. I don't understand. I don't know. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This, brothers, wallahi, this amazing characteristics, amazing subject, it just really shocked my core inside. My, I'm talking about myself. When Abu Dujana is very, very high rank Sahabi. Very high rank. The warrior, the bravest in the battlefield. Very famous, read about him. When he is dying, he said, they saw him so happy, dying and happy. And he said to him, can he explain to us, tell us? He says, wallahi, I have two things that I'm putting all my hopes in. That's why I'm so happy. Number one, I don't interfere in the affairs of others. I don't put my nose in anything. And the second one, my heart is so clean towards every Muslim. He didn't mention Badr or Uhud or the battles or nothing. He mentioned two things that every one of us, we all said, no, this is small things. Let me focus on the big things. What big things, brother? You misunderstand. Imam Shafi'i says, if your tongue can really speak about the negative things of others, before you say something, think that others have tongues too. And there are many of them. And when your eyes see the wrong in others, remember that others have eyes too. SubhanAllah. If we remember before we send this message or that email or blurt, whatever it is, about others in the back, wallahi, we will be in Jannah before Jannah. If we have that beautiful, beautiful heart, like the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his Sahaba, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us with them in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our mistakes and shortcomings. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers, wallahi, the stories about this husn al-dhan, positive feeling, positive impression, interpreting whatever the family, the brother, the sister, the relative do in a good way, being humble and busy ourselves with our mistakes and shortcomings. We're not perfect. You know what Shaitan does? He makes us interpret and think of others' mistakes that we forget our own mistakes. We are so busy what this group are doing, what this group is doing, what this brother is doing, what this sister is doing, that we forget that, the mountain we have of mistakes and bad deeds. And this is one of the biggest tricks of Shaitan. Focus on ourselves. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Allah says in the Quran, عَلَيْكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ. Be first and foremost, fix yourself. Look inwards. You can mock and ridicule your own actions, but not others. As we say, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you remember this story of the Iraqi famous scholar Al-Karkhi shocked you, making dua for people drinking and dancing in the river? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, somebody was brought to him, not once, many times, somebody being caught drinking alcohol. And the people start to curse him, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, stop, don't curse him. I know that he loves Allah and his messenger. Subhanallah. Look at what he is trying to focus his, you know, everybody's directions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, somebody came to him from the poor and needy, from the Bedouin, living in the desert just by themselves. They have no idea how to speak to human. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is giving, And he gave to this man, and he said, happy? He said, no, I'm not happy. And he lashes out at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the Sahaba really stand to defend and protect. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam signaled to them, calm down. And he takes him and takes the man, the poor man inside the house, and he gives him more. You happy now? Yes, I'm happy now. You are the best of mankind. You are the best, you're most just generous and kind. He says to him, subhanallah, my companion are really, you know, feeling bad about what he said outside. Can I get you to repeat this outside so they can calm down? And he takes him to the masjid and he said, the brother came with me inside the house and he's very happy now. Are you happy now? He says, yes, I'm happy. This is the best. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is trying to teach us, calm down, think positive, make dua for good things. Make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us. Don't always be angry. Don't always say the bad things. You know, I do 100 good deeds and one bad deed, that's all you remember from me, one bad deed. You remember when you told me off? You remember he shouted? Remember? No. It's hard, it's not easy. It's not easy. That's why we keep, everybody almost go to the easy way of getting angry and lashing out and or sulking and not talking, all this horrible, horrible treatment to family, especially family. Brothers and sisters, we have nobody in this country. We are minorities, only a few of us in every suburbs. We cannot afford to have war inside the home. We cannot afford to have our children not happy. No matter what they do, no matter how they behave. I say that. No matter what they do, no matter how they behave, the home should be home, should be peaceful, should be a place of tranquility, of serenity, of trust. I know we have so much problem in our work and career and study and family, all these things. Allah knows that, and Allah put us in this test, and He has wisdom for it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us reason for happiness and success wherever we are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our families and fill our home with peace and success and happiness in the dunya and the deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise our rank in this life and the next. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidul majid. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfina fi amrina. وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على من عادانا اللهم فرج كرب المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم ارفع الظلم عن المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم ارفع الظلم عن المظلمين في كل مكان اللهم اهدنا واهد أولادنا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.